Just these. I don't want the others.
Come on, man. I schlepped these all the way here.
There's people waiting.
You know, you don't have to be so disrespectful. You've actually carried my books here.
And you are?
Lee Israel.
Oh, we have copies of your latest work right over there.
Nobody is going to pay for the writer Lee Israel right now.
I'm months behind in my rent, and my cat is sick.
It's 4 in the afternoon, and you're drunk.
I'm hardly drunk.
Craigie.
No problem. Always a pleasure to see you.
Likewise, right back at you.
And really enjoyed this movie because you often wonder what would happen to a person if they got their back so far pushed up against a wall. You know, what would they do to, I don't want to say escape, but, you know, to pay
to
their
survive.
Bills, right?
To survive. I thought about that, too. It's like, you know, what would any of us do? I mean, the one thing she did well, she was told she's obsolete. Don't do it anymore. Mm-hmm. She didn't have the flexibility to just adapt into something else. Not by choice. She just really couldn't do it. And I couldn't help thinking, like, if my family needed something, if you just had to pay your, my God, rent, food, mm-hmm. medicine, what do you do? And I don't know anyone who can give a solid answer that they wouldn't go farther than they think.
I suppose that because Lee Israel got away with the first letter that she forged, then you think, well, if you've got this amount of money back and nobody's rumbled you, nobody's hurt because the great writers are dead and their reputations are intact. In fact, she was doing kind of enhancement on their literary reputations. So the fact that she got away with it for as long as she did and wrote over 400 letters is testament to her real ventriloquist literary talent, that she was able to imitate these writers so expertly.
Quite by accident, I find myself in a rather criminal position.
What criminal activity could possibly involve it, except a crime of fashion, of course?
I'm embellishing literary letters by prominent writers.
I love his writing.
Particularly clever, don't you think?
Caustic wit.
This is quite something. He's a wonderful.
I thought so, too.
Name your price.
You were looking at 1 month's rent.
The weird part is, who does she wind up becoming close with? The character played by Richard, which you're talking about oil and water.
Totally. On the surface, yes. Mm-hmm. I thought, what a wildly unlikely pair. And then the more I kind of thought about them, I thought, but they're both so lonely. They're both quite desperate. And I don't know, there was something in me that I just thought, it seems to make sense that at that time, that exact moment when they met, they probably both just needed someone to see them, all their flaws, bumps, bruises, and say that's okay.
He's homeless, you know, between jobs, between partners, between, he's just in between. So he's a real opportunist who, you know, is completely hedonistic. As soon as he's got $10, it just burns a hole through his pocket. He's got to spend it and have a good time.
And there was one scene where your character's there and she used a $2 bill as a bookmark. Who had seen a $2 bill?
I know. When we were looking through everything, I was like, can you get me a $2 bill? Because even back then, I remember being like, ooh, this is neat. But now it's like it never existed. So
well,
I can't believe you noticed that.
Ironically, I went to the store yesterday before going to see the screening. And this is
Are
what
you
I got
kidding?
Paid. I'm serious.
I have not seen one in probably 10 years.
Wow.
I mean, other than when we were shooting.
And it was like, something must be up with the $2 bill.
You conjured it.
I did. I'll let you know what happens.
Start thinking of better things. I can't say that I regret any of my actions. In many ways, this has been the best time of my life.